Hey, Angel here for mynexttablet.com, today with an unboxing of the TechLast P10, a very inexpensive Android tablet. Alright, let's start the unboxing of the TechLast P10. As I said, it's a very inexpensive Android tablet. It starts at around $110, but there's a coupon right now so that you can get it for $99.99 only, which is very, very inexpensive. This one is mostly sold in China, but you can import it very easily to wherever you are, United States, Europe, or all over Asia. The guys from GearBest sent it to me, and that's one of the shops that is selling the TechLast P10. And as I said, with the coupon code, it's only $99.99 right now, which is certainly very cheap. So let's take a look at this tablet and unbox it. First, we'll put it to the side to see what else is inside the box here. Now here we've got a warranty card and some manual. It's mostly in Chinese though. Oh no, there's some English as well. That's certainly good. And then here we've got a standard USB to micro USB cable. So it seems like there is no power plug inside here, but it's, as you can see, a standard USB cable. So you probably have one lying around. I think I have the final retail packaging. So yeah, you probably have to use power plugs that you already own, or I have to buy one. They are not very expensive, so that should be fine. Alright, let's take a look at the TechLast P10. I already unboxed it actually, because I really wanted to try out some benchmarks. And yeah, that's why I can turn it on already. It's connected to Wi-Fi and my Google account. Alright, one of the highlights of this tablet is the 10.1-inch screen, because it offers a full HD resolution with 1920x1200. Most tablets at this price from more famous brands offer an HD resolution only, and that includes the Lenovo Tab 4 series and the Huawei MediaPad T3 series that go for around $150. So they're more expensive but only have an HD resolution. But well, TechLast is not that famous brand, so that's why they're offering a full HD screen here, and that's certainly nice. I already reviewed the Honda V10 4G, and while that was certainly fine for the price, I didn't like it too much because it felt quite cheap. Now that one had 4G, this one is Wi-Fi only, and they apparently used that money to give us a full aluminium body, which is certainly nice. It feels much nicer than the Honda V10 4G because, well, it's aluminium. There's only a little bit of plastic here for the Wi-Fi antennas, and there's a 5-megapixel camera, by the way. But yeah, it certainly feels more high-end. It's not super thin though, it's around 9.9 millimeters, so almost a centimeter. Yeah, but that's fine. I really like that we're getting aluminium at just under $100. All right, let's take a look at the ports here. We've got a standard 3.5 millimeter audio jack, micro SD card slot, a micro USB port, and then this is actually another power plug, but there's no cable or charge included. So I don't know, you can probably charge it with this one as well, but the micro USB port certainly works for charging. I tried it already. Then we've got a speaker here, a speaker on the other side, so dual speakers, nothing on the bottom. On the top we've got a power button, volume rockers, and probably a microphone, and then a 2-megapixel front-facing camera, and as I mentioned, the 10.1-inch IPS screen. By the way, this is an IPS panel with relatively good viewing angles, as you can see here. It's also relatively bright, really not too bad. But what I already noticed, and what's the case with most, you know, cheaper tablets, is that there's a gap between the touchscreen and the IPS panel. Now, this is certainly not a problem with tablets out of China only. The new Samsung Galaxy Tab A 8.1 2017 has a gap as well, and even the 2017 iPad. Yeah, so that's a problem with cheaper tablets, if you want to call it a problem. It's certainly not super nice. While you can use it as usual, it's more reflective that way, like it will transform into a mirror a bit more easily than we are used to otherwise. All right, in here runs a ROCm processor together with 2 GB of RAM and a 32 GB internal storage. And out of those 32 GB, I took a screenshot before I installed anything, are only 3.2 gigabytes that are used by the system. So that's certainly nice. So you've got a lot of storage to use for yourself. And the ROCm processor is an RK3368. That's an octa-core chip clocked at 1.5 gigahertz. So on that chip, I really wanted to try out how the performance is, and that's why I installed Geekbench 4 and Antutu, and we can have a look at the benchmarks results now. And this is Geekbench 4, single core test is around 550 and the multi-core test around 1800, and that's just below a typical Snapdragon 425 processor that's found in the Huawei MediaPad T3 series, Lenovo Tab 4 series, and the new Samsung Galaxy Tab A 2017. But what's really interesting is that in Antutu it actually gets better results than a typical Snapdragon 425 tablet, and that's why I wanted to install Modern Combat 5 that we will take a look at very soon. But let's take a look at the software first. As you can see, there's no heavy customized user interface here. It's pretty much vanilla Android, and that's very nice. There are not a lot of apps pre-installed. There's a TechLast OTA app, a video app, and otherwise the standard Google apps, including Chrome and the Play Store, so you can install apps yourself. I installed Antutu, Geekbench, and Modern Combat 5 myself, so they're not pre-installed, but they're all free to download, and it's certainly nice. We also have a screenshot button here, louder and more silent button here, the volume controls, and that's pretty much it. So it's kind of vanilla Android without any heavy customizations, and that's something I really like. On here runs Android 7.1.2 Android, by the way, so it's fairly recent. Obviously no Oreo yet, but as of right now there's no tablet running Oreo, so that's not something we can expect from a tablet that costs $99.99. So let's start the browser and just surf around a bit. I already just tested the browser a bit, and it certainly should be fine for most things. Obviously at $100 you don't get the best performance out there, but it should certainly be fine for browsing the web, watching some YouTube, maybe doing some office work. That are certainly things that I will test in detail. I always try to work for about a week with a tablet, like work in meaning and writing articles with this and so on. And yeah, we will see how that works in my final review. Let's just start Modern Combat 5 now so that we can have a little gaming test here. And with tablets that cost around $150, like the Lenovo Tab 4 and Huawei MediaPad T3 series, and those run Asphalt Extreme nicely and a lot of games nicely, but they suffer heavy lags in Modern Combat 5. And since Antutu benchmark is a bit better here, that's why I wanted to try out Modern Combat 5 in my unboxing video already. And then we will see that it's surprisingly good. The graphics don't look nice at all, but you can play it relatively smoothly, and certainly much better than the Snapdragon 425 tablets I reviewed from a more famous brand that might offer better support and warranty. I'm not sure how the warranty support here is. But yeah, those couldn't play Modern Combat 5 nicely. But with this one, I noticed that it's actually playable. As you can see, while I move around here, the graphics don't look nice, but you can play it. And that's certainly the most important thing. That means that other games like Asphalt Extreme usually runs everywhere, and other games should work as well, like Dead Trigger 2 maybe. Alright, so as you can see, it's certainly playable. With other tablets, cheaper tablets, you sometimes see some heavy lag during action heavy sequences like we have here right now, where you have to shoot somebody, and that's really annoying, which makes it not much fun. But this one is certainly playable. As I said, it does not offer the best performance, you can't expect that at $100, but the performance is certainly better than I'm used to from the Huawei MediaPad T3 or the Samsung Galaxy Tab A80, which I'm reviewing right now as well. Alright, and that's basically it. My first impressions of the TechLast P10. I have to review it now, start my review, do battery tests, performance tests, gaming tests, and yeah, use it for a while. But my first impressions are not bad at all at this price. The Full HD screen is pretty nice. Obviously, there's a gap which is not that nice, but most competitors have that as well. The performance seems good, not outstanding, but pretty good, especially at this price. And yeah, the build quality is not too bad either. Now, I really hope that I won't see any major downsides while reviewing this, because it seems to be quite a nice deal. But yeah, I will have my review up maybe in 2-3 weeks when I'm done with it, and then I can tell you more about the TechLast P10. If you've got any questions, just write them down below. Oh, by the way, you can win the TechLast P10 right now. I've got a giveaway on mynexttablet.com/giveaway, and that's not this one. You will get a completely new one, and yeah, if you go to mynexttablet.com/giveaway, then you can participate in a giveaway. You basically just have to leave a comment, and then yeah, you have the chance of winning this tablet. All right, I'm Andrzej for mynexttablet.com. Thanks for watching.